But up next, we take you back to rowing. The U.S. Women's 8 unexpectedly with some work to do in the middle of the week. Let's go to Lake Lanier for the story.
If we execute properly, we can win this. And I think if we don't win, I think it'll be a disappointment because we know that we should. If we don't win, we will have screwed up in some way.
The voice of Betsy McCagg. The U.S. Women's 8, feeling the pressure of being the favorite, stumbled in their heat, completely overlooking Belarus. But today, the repechage. Today, they have their second chance. And welcome once again to beautiful Lake Lanier, some 55 miles northeast of downtown Atlanta. We're getting set now for the Women's 8 repechage. America's team, after that poor showing in the heats, what are their chances today, Bob?
Well, they've got a great chance today, Charlie. What they really have to do is just finish in the top four out of this six-boat heat, and I think they can manage that easily.
What about the conditions of the course today?
Oh, the conditions are excellent. There was a little head breeze the other day, but it's flatter than a mirror out here today, and really fast conditions.
Now let's move inside the mind of their coach, Hartmut Buschbacher, and get his comments on this race.
Again, I think we tried to prepare. We said we in favor, but it doesn't mean anything. You have to do it. You have to pull it off on a certain day. And so we didn't do this, but I think that will reinforce them. Okay, we really got to come up with something, what we actually did in training so far. So I think it's more right now, can we perform this with the pressure in here in our home soil or not? And I think that's where it comes down, and I think we can.
We've all heard the quote, grace under pressure. Well, this must be performance under pressure today.
That's right. They've got to perform today, or their medal chances are going to end here today.
We'll be back in just a moment with the Women's 8 repechage. America's team, can they move through? As we look down on the most beautiful of all of the Olympic venues, Lake Lanier, we're getting set for the only repechage of the Women's 8. There will be six boats, four to the finals on Sunday, and that is it. Here are the lane assignments with Australia in one, Germany in two, United States is in three, Canada is four, the Netherlands in five, Great Britain is in six. And America's team, United States in lane three, and there is a look at the Women's 8. Yas Farouk is the coxswain, and their hearts must be beating a little bit faster here, Bob.
I don't think there's any question about that. They absolutely crushed the Belarusians in Lucerne earlier this summer, and they just were not ready for that race on Monday.
Lane one at the top of the screen, so countdown one, two, three. That is the United States team in lane three, and there they are. And it is imperative they get off to a good start.
Well, my guess is Hartmut Buschbacher, their coach, sat down with them and made it the point that you've got to get this boat rolling fast, and you've got to get yourself in the hunt early on.
Six boats again. Remember, four to the finals on Sunday, and the other two, in reality, they go home as far as the medals are concerned. Yas Farouk is the coxswain for the United States. In the eighth seat, the stroke, that is Jen Dory. Behind her, Amy Fuller. In the sixth seat, Monica Trinnell Machini. And then it's Betsy McCagg and Katrina Fallon, Laurel Korhos, Mary McCagg, and Annie Summertime Kakala.
Well, the Americans are coming out a little better than they did on Monday, I think. But certainly the Canadians want to make their statement early on here. The Canadians and the British down here in lane six did a great job in the Olympic qualification regatta in Lucerne earlier this summer. And I think they're going to surprise a lot of people. And the Americans want to get themselves in that top four and get it early so that they can maybe relax a little bit here.
Hartmut Buschbacher also said, we'll be making a few adjustments. We'll be back to where we were 4 weeks ago. It's not too complicated, and he is not worried. We're on board with the Canadians, and you better worry about the Canadians. They're looking good.
Oh, they've got great technique here, and they had a super start. They're up on the field, and they're really moving. And going through the first 500, it's the Canadians and the Americans, 1-2.
Counting up from the bottom of the screen, Great Britain, Netherlands, Canada leading, then the United States in second, and above them, Germany and Australia.
I think the American crew's moving pretty well right now. Their strong suit, what they do best is the middle 1,000 meters of the course. They've got a lot of big, strong women in that boat, and they can make it move. And I think they're doing a pretty good job right now.
One of the American women, after their disaster in the heat, was on NPR, National Public Radio, and she said, for us to do well, we must row 8 as 1. And in the heat, we were rowing 8 as 8. We were all over the place, and they were.
Well, and through the 1,000 meters, the Canadians are still leading by about a quarter of a length on the Americans. And remember, there's not a real necessity to finish first in this repechage, but I think the Americans would like to finish first in this repechage to get themselves pumped up a little bit, to be confident a little bit more.
We go on board with the Canadians. What is the importance of legs in rowing?
Well, the actual rowing stroke, about 80% of the force comes from the actual leg drive, and that's why the boats are built this way, with seats that slide, and the feet are actually connected to the boats by little shoes.
37 strokes a minute for Canada.
And they're moving well. They've got a third of the length now on the Americans.
They are moving together. How are the Americans rowing? Are they together?
I think they're doing a good job today. And I think that there's a good chance in this last 700 or 800 meters here, they're going to come up and challenge the Canadians.
Also, an interesting reaction after the last outing for the American women, when they all felt like they blamed themselves. They all took the responsibility. It was my fault, and took it upon themselves to get ready for this race.
Well, here they are on their home court. They're the favorites. They're the defending world champions. And, you know, you can't help but think that they weren't a little bit embarrassed by that. But now they're back on their game, and I'm sure that by the time this weekend rolls around, they'll be ready for the final.
500 meters to go. It is Canada and the United States again. This is the only repechage in the women's eight. So four of these boats will move through to the finals on Sunday. Belarus and Romania are already in the final. The other two here, they're out of the medal race.
Well, this is getting to be a really close race now. This angle of the camera is a little bit deceptive. The camera's a little bit behind the bows, so you can't really tell how even this is. And I don't think there's going to be any crews in this American crew today, Charlie.
The United States closing on Canada and may just be edging out in front just ever so much over them.
Well, you can see that coxswain Yasmin Farouk is not telling them to just get in the top four. They want to make sure that the Canadians know that when this weekend gets here, the Americans are getting the medal, and the talent and the Canadians can get something else.
They are neck and neck, the United States and Canada. Yaz, the coxswain, said, we didn't train this long to come out here and lose.
Well, and this is a great race. It's a great race. It's neck and neck between the Canadians and the U.S. crew, and this could come down to the last stroke.
And the Canadians, of course, they want to beat the Americans to set themselves up for a medal. It is Canada and the United States to see who is going to win the repechage. But remember, the top four are going to move through, and right now it is United States just barely in front, and now with some 20 meters to go, it's United States and Canada. United States by half a deck. They've got it. One, two.
What a super race. Boy, I'll tell you, it just couldn't be any better out here at Lake Lanier.
And a great row by America's team, the U.S. women.
Well, they did exactly what they needed to do today. They got to the line first, and I think they're going to pump themselves up a little bit with this.
They had their cheering section of some 16,000. We look again at the bubble finish line from overhead. That is the United States and then Canada. And they had all of the American rowers were out to cheer them on. Here are the official results. United States, Canada, Netherlands, and Australia move through.
All right, Charlie Jones, thank you. So they do it the hard way, but they get the job done. The U.S. Women's Eight now into the final, where they will try to repeat their victory at last year's World Championships.